Hi GD Channel viewers and welcome to another episode of our legendary visits. And today we are at Fujitsubo, which is one of the biggest aftermarket parts manufacturers for the JDM tuning world. And we're going to be taking a look at the inside of the facility and also be talking to the engineer on how they actually design and to all these details, and also be checking out one of their cars, the GR Supra, hopefully in a future episode. Now, Fujitsubo is one of the biggest aftermarket manufacturers for specifically exhaust systems. They also make other products like exhaust manifolds and downpipes, or rather front pipes, as it's known in Japan, for turbocharged cars, and also a special spots catalyzers. But of course, the most famous products are the exhaust systems known as the Ligalis R, which is very famous from the 90s magazines of Hyper-Rev, and some of you probably know from different tuning companies. They also have other products like the RM01, which is race-derived, and the Power Getter, and of course, recently, the Authorized series. Now, very popular in the JDM tuning world are these very well-known names. Now, the facility here, just past Gotemba, right outside of Mount Fuji, where you can see a spectacular view of the mountain, is a quiet little countryside area where the facility lies in. And if you'd like to check out the full factory review, you can look at the JDM Masters factory tour review of this facility. And we look inside at how these finely crafted, almost mechanical metallurgy, wonderful pieces are made here in the factory. We also get a chance to sample some of their engineering and some of their products. There's some test cars, which we'll be looking at. They have an R34 GTR, and they still do make a lot of parts for older cars and also newer cars, European cars. We're going to be looking from the start to finish how the design of such an exhaust is made, ensuring the performance, reliability and quality, but also interchangeability, where the customer is usually assured of a well-finished product that is at world standards. And of course, this factory has ISO standards, and in Japan, it's got the JASMA approval, which means it's street legal, which is a very, very important point. Many smaller makers do make exhausts that give you a lot of power, but perhaps they might annoy your neighbors because the decibels are actually very loud. But all of Fujitsubo's exhaust systems are within the legislation and restrictions levels that you can safely bring them out to the street and will not be caught for having illegal parts. It's a very important point, and we'd like to focus on why this exhaust could be a very important tuning part in your car. If not, it's just to improve the sound of your very quiet OEM exhaust, which, let's be honest, a lot of people, you know, do change exhaust purely for sound. So let's go have a look and talk with the R&D engineer. So this is the CAD room, or the design room, rather. CAD stands for computer-aided design. And this is the process in where the 3D drawing, or rather a 3D model, is made of any products. And this is something very usual in the industry. So today we're going to be looking at how these mufflers and exhaust parts are made. There's two kinds of different processes, but what we're interested in is the process of how the legendary Ligalis muffler parts were made. And so we're going to be talking with the design engineer, and he'll explain to us how they use these models, and they do a 3D camera scan, and it goes into the data, and the data is then used to process and make a model on using polygons on the CAD, and then after that, it goes to different trial and error test runs, and like the dyno run that you saw, and then with testing and going out. And so it's a whole process of actually just making small adjustments and making different parts before they come to a final conclusion. And of course, the object of this whole exercise is to create more power, and that's what you buy an aftermarket exhaust for. Of course, you want good sound, but it's also compliant, but you want high quality. And this is where we're going to be learning the little secrets where top manufacturer like Fujitsubo actually go through their process. Thank you for allowing us to see your room.
My name is Yoichi Hanatsuka. I'm a design engineer.
Thank you very much. So can you explain to us, how do you make the designs for this exhaust?
車の下で、試作車が、テールパイプですとか、あとはメインパイプですとか、フランジの位置を決めたものを、ここで何をするかというと、 より試作者が作ったものをこうもう少しこう精度を上げるために、まあ、パイプのレイアウトですとか、あとその、レイアウトだとかの形状だとかを、まあ、より現場に作りやすいような形でデータを作っていくんですね。
Looks like a video game.
yes.
It's amazing. So they make the designs of the aftermarket products. Of course, you know, everything has to be designed using computer-aided design. It's something not new, but of course the software has improved. And so the engineers at the technicians who are at the car, once they make the prototypes, and they fit it together, and then those designs are then put into this. All right, and here we have it.
Thank you.
This is the pure 2D CAD drawing.
Yes.
And so you have all of the measurements of each of the sections. And of course, you have the diameter, and you have the section by section. If there's a small curve, each measurement needs to be laid out very, very accurately. And this is down to millimeters.
Yes.
0.03 millimeters.
これを、まあ、パイプ加工の現場にデータとして渡してあげて、この図面を渡してあげて、でこの図面を渡してきて現物ができてきたりとかすると、まあ、試作者が溶接で切り継ぎでつないでた部品が一つの曲げとして出来上がってくる。
これをのデータを使って自作品を作る。
そうですね。これを図面を作ってきたものが元々はこう継ぎはぎだらけのものなんですけど、継ぎはぎだらけのものがああいう曲げになって出てくるわけです。
はい。ああ、I see. そうすると富士坪に持ってるデザイン、まあ、ベースカラーを作ってで、まあ、
そう試作者がベースを作るんですね。でベースを作るのがディティールを作るのが、まあ、私たちの仕事ではありますね。
例えば形状を変えりたいだとしたら、例えばインターナルダイメーター、それも1個ずつもプロトタイプを作ってるんですか？
例えばじゃあこれをやっぱりこの試作はこの形状を作ったけど、ここに何ミリ上げたいとか径を上げたいとかっていうのはまたこっちでもできるので。
分かりました、一つの商品が出来上がるまでこれ何回やったんですか？普通に
一発で決まる時ももちろんあるんですけど。
そうですか。
でもやっぱり時間がかかると何十回も試作する時はありますよ。
90年代の車の中でどんな車種が一番作りが大変だったんですか？
私が聞いた話だと R34 が大変だったっていう話は、やっぱり馬力がもともとある車で、
はい、
でやっぱり馬力を出さなくちゃならない、でも音は規制の中で守らなきゃ、レギュレーションに守らなきゃならないっていうのもあって、それが大変でした。
I see.So the most difficult car from the 90s to make and design a muffler was the R34 GTR, because the car already has a lot of power, but because of the changing regulations and also the noise levels, in order to make that, to fit those conditions was very, very difficult. Of course, then as cars get newer, like the newer Impreza, the Evolution 10, noise and regulation levels become more and more strict.So it becomes more and more difficult to create a muffler or an exhaust system that can create power yet have the low noise level, right? And you're saying that also foreign cars in Japan, European cars like the BMW M2, M3, it's really difficult to produce. So it's these ongoing challenges which makes this process of carefully designing each part and testing it,really, really important. And sometimes it takes several tries, maybe 10, 9 times, but sometimes they can get it done correctly with just one go.
車は、Yaris の GR4 です。
This is for the Yaris?
Yaris.
Oh, GR Yaris. It's a new model which has just come out, so this is a brand new design.
Yes.
With this exhaust, how much more power?
5馬力ぐらい上がった。
It is, yes. But what's your...expected power to get?
5馬力ぐらいですね、確か。
5 maximum horsepower.
それでも5馬力ぐらいしか上がらない。
What about torque? 2 kilos?
5ぐらいだったと思いました。
Wow, 5 kilograms of torque from the 1.6 liter. That's quite a lot. I'm not sure. The authorized series?
Yes.
For the GR Yaris. And it's the final design.
Final design.
So you expect it to get about 5 more horsepower, maximum horsepower, and about 3 to 5 more kilograms of torque. That's quite a lot. Just doing a cat-back exhaust muffler change. That's pretty good from a 1.6-liter engine. 馬力を出すためにこのデザイン的にネックですか？やっぱりあのストレートの方の方がいい。
ストレートの方がいいんですけど、やっぱりあとは音の規制がすごく厳しいので、なかなかこれ以上あのやろうとする。今もすでにもう音はギリギリなんですよ。
I see.So it's pretty difficult to make an aftermarket part that can fulfill the noise levels but yet give enough power because, you know, if they were to make it straight, definitely will give a lot of power, but that would exceed the decibel rating, be too loud. So one of the points of this split design is to actually keep power levels at a good range but also keep it quiet. Can we look at this 3D scanner? Yeah.
図面を作るのに、データを作る必要があるので、これで計測をして、で CAD データ化してという、準備段階としてこれを測定しておきます。
はい、そもそもこのものは、作ったものです。
そうです。これはあのパイプが、これは
例えばメーカーが、純正ものを作ってるわけね。でそれを測定して、でカード入れて、じゃあ、ちょっといじって、でプロトタイプを作る。でこれは何回繰り返すってことですか？
そう、そういうこともありますし、あとはこれもやなんでしょう、パイプが1本のパイプ、2本のパイプって、みんな継ぎはぎで作ってあるので、これって今こっちは別々じゃないですか。でもこっちは一体じゃないですか。
そうなんです。So as you can see here, there are two different types of tailpieces on the muffler. One has actually split and one doesn't have. So using this 3D scanner, in order to make this, he will actually scan sections of the pipe. That data is fed into the computer and another 3D model is made. And after that, it will be processed and made into a one-piece pipe, which will look closer to the final product. So there's many uses of this 3D scanning machine. One of the other things that is usually done is to take the original OEM part from the new car, and so they can get the dimensions, the exact curvature of each part of the pipe, and then redesign it to make an aftermarket part, which will then become closer to the final product. Sometimes this is a repetitive process through trial and error that needs to be done and again and again. But thankfully, with these modern machines,And of course, great software, and of course, the skill of the engineers and the designers to understand what needs to be done. It's just part and parcel of this whole design process. So, can we have a demonstration?
Yes.
So, the scanner uses infrared, because infrared is very easy to go over all the small little shapes and bumps. And so now we can see after he runs the infrared camera and scans it.On all the surfaces around this solid 3D muffler, and it appears on the screen like a very dark image. And you can see that it's got different shades, and it's obviously an image of the 3D shape of the original. And if it just keeps going throughout all the entire shapes, and then eventually become a 3D object that can be fed into the CAD.Polygon maker over there, just keep it simple. And, you know, what's more important is that these tiny dimensions can then be modified to be made either bigger in one area or the other, and which is very important in making something like an exhaust system, because usually exhaust systems for aftermarket makers are bigger than the stock ones. Just make it a lot easier in order to have the data for literally thousands of differentmodels, which is one of the reasons why a maker like Fujitsubo can actually have the capacity to make different models very quickly for different cars, and you know, churn it out as products with that high level of quality and also assured performance. Thank you so much for your explanation.
ありがとうございました。
Hope to see you again next time, and please tell us more about how you make other kinds of parts.
ありがとうございました。ありがとうございました。
So we hope you enjoyed this little talk with the engineers and looking at how mufflers and exhaust systems and exhaust manifolds are designed from the beginning process to the end. And let us know in the comments if you'd like us to go deeper into other types of car parts, maybe turbochargers or intakes, or even, you know, just other kinds of manufacturers as well. And let us know in the comments what you think. Maybe you want us to go to other manufacturers as well. And until next time, see you.